All right. Here we are back again on the second part of this video for you. So total energy equals potential energy plus kinetic energy. No matter where we are in the system, that is always true. So here, one of them is zero. Which one is zero this time? Morgan?
PE.
Pardon?
PE.
Potential energy is gone. It's all kinetic energy because it's right before it hits. There is no more height. So PE is all gone. So this zeroes out. So here TE is all kinetic. And this is where you need to have your brain trained, right here. And it is TE equals PE plus KE. So that I don't have numbers to give you because I don't have real heights that I've written in this problem or real velocities. But if I had them, TE equals PE plus KE. So this is total energy. It's the same throughout the whole system. So this number, TE here, is the same as TE here, is the same as TE here. Total energy is the same. Every system, every spot. All right, let's erase that. How much do you need there, Jonathan?
All the TEs?
All right. Give me a little spot. I need to write smaller, don't I? All right, what we're going to establish now is we're going to jump right. Remember when we did those problems where the Earth was going around the sun and you had this mass and this velocity, find this period and so forth? I did one problem and you went and did all the different kinds of problems. It was really beautiful. Other years, I probably showed this is how you do it when they give you T, and you have to find the velocity. This is how you do it when I give you velocity and period, and you have to find orbital radius. But I didn't. I did one problem, and you figured out the rest yourself. So guess what? I'm going to do that again. I'm going to do one problem. If you can give me your brain for this one problem, you will be set for the rest of the day. So let me give you that.
Say year.
If we get it right, can we take a nap?
I know.
You got it. Nap time.
Well, we don't have
the check.
I don't care. I'll lay down for 2 minutes.
Exactly. I need more board space here, so I'll just wait a second. Have you got this yet?
You can raise the left. The far left.
Okay, that's all I need. Thank you.
What else do you put it in?
All right.
You put it back in your shovel.
If I wrote smaller, I could have more sections on my board here. All right, here it is. I want you to draw a roller coaster. We're going to be on a roller coaster all day today. There we are, visions of Hershey Park.
When's physics day?
I don't know. Sometimes in May.
Are we going?
Do you really want to go?
Yes!
Because I'll tell you, we went last year. It is so crowded.
Can we go
so crowded
year?
That well,
can we go math day?
I went. Is it any less crowded?
I think it was. When we
I think
went
it was.
One,
it was
why don't we just go on a day that's not like any kind of special?
They're
day.
Not open that time of year.
I thought they're
not open, and they're just open for math and physics until
really?
Till May till Memorial Day.
Oh my gosh.
So anyway. They open just for
really
these
weird.
Kind of things, but I went on physics day. It was so crowded. You just stood in line. I probably went on 5 rides the whole day. No, maybe more than that.
Well,
and it was hot,
it was
and then it
fun.
Poured
the
down rain,
was
and it was
yeah, awful. Math day was
and
okay.
If you wait until like 4 o'clock, all the school groups clear out, and then we just like
went and
yeah,
then you
that'd
just,
be an
then
idea.
You, like,
we went
around.
To math
that
day.
That might
yeah.
be an idea.
I think it was math day.
And then you
yeah,
split
well,
up.
We
did you go late? You didn't go late.
No, we stayed the whole day, but then we just stayed a little bit.
What grade was that when we went on math day? Was that
8th grade?
Well, yeah, but it wasn't that crowded that day.
No.
All right, well, I'll look into it. Miss McManus usually goes, so I'll see
yeah.
if she's going this year, too.
Yes.
All right, thank you. All right.
I like the things you do in the beginning.
I like
you eat all the
fun.
I've
never
been
to all of
them. All right.
I've only been once and I was like,
all right, back to this one. Let us look at...
I'll just jump in.
Let us look at, for reference, I'm going to call the first hill A, And the second hill B, the height of hill A is 113 meters. So write this down as I do. Height of hill B is, actually, I'm going to call the valley B and the second hill C. Can you change that, please? And the height at the valley is 22. And the height at C, I can't read my writing. I think it's 67. Okay. Who would help? All right. You got that? We're going to put a cart on the top. And this big cart, I'll put my A over here so I can draw my cart. This is a roller coaster. I just put one car. There's a whole bunch of them. So that has a mass of 546 kilograms. All right, now I want you to find the speed of this cart at B, the valley, and C, the top. We're going to say that we're going to say it's going to start at rest. That's unusual. So you're usually not, this is sort of training. So we're going to start it at rest. It'll be easier if we do that. So imagine the car has come to a total stop. It's sort of a dramatic pause, and then it's going to coast down. So it's not like a real roller coaster. It's some physics class roller coaster. So write down these parameters, the heights, the A, B, and C reference points, that it's starting at rest, the question, find the speed at B, point B and C. The first step on this one and all the ones we're going to do is find total energy. Where do I go to find total energy? The easiest spot. I can find total energy anywhere, but the easiest spot is where it's all potential or it's all kinetic. Can you find such a spot, Molly? Pardon?
A.
A. Because it's resting here. There's no motion, there's no kinetic energy, so all of it is potential energy. So TE equals PE at A, so that's what that means. The potential energy, if I calculate it at A, that is the total energy. So what's that, MGH? Calculators, help me with this. The mass is 546, the G is 9.8. And the height is 113. So I need some tippy taps, two sig figs. What are we getting?
That's a very large number.
604, yeah, it is.
640.4.
What?
604.640.4.
So in two figs, sig figs, 6.0 times 10 to the what?
4.
10 to the 4.
5. It's 5.
Which is it?
Oh, yeah, 5.
5, you okay with that?
Right.
All right. That's joules. I won't write joules throughout the problem, but I just, the first time, I will write it there. So the potential energy is the total energy. Because remember, like the boulder that was at the top of the cliff, that was all potential. So total energy and potential energy at A are the same. So that's always the starting point. Find the total energy in the system. All right, now we're going to switch over to point B. At point B, I know that total energy equals potential energy at B plus kinetic energy at B. This is like when the boulder is halfway down. Remember, there's some potential and there's some kinetic. If I know the two and add them up, it will equal total. But I already know the total. I stole it from point A where it was easy to calculate it. So it's going to be the same at point B, the total energy. Is that clear? The total energy is the same every point. So I went to point A to calculate it, but I'm going to use it at point B. So I put in 6.0. times E, I like that EE button for that. Potential energy is MGH at B. Kinetic energy is 1/2 MV squared at B. All right, help me find some of those numbers. All right, are you up? When you get up, Alex, to this point, tell me some of the MGHs.